China aims to achieve a GDP growth target of about 5% for 2024, according to a government work report submitted to the National Legislature for deliberation. The report has outlined major pro-growth steps to drive economy, including boosting consumption. According to the government work report, China will launch a year-long program to stimulate consumption and promote steady growth in consumption spending.
其实你会发现越来越多的年轻人开始喜欢这些国潮的产品，这些国潮产品背后一个是非遗的传承，然后包括这些民族的手工艺，然后很多都是传承了千年的手艺，然后今天我们从大山深处，然后让这些时尚的设计师跟绣娘们一起去创造了这些有着独特的设计感和这个美学的这种韵味的这些产品，然后现在成为年轻人的最爱。
我们今年春节，整个春节的这个观众量，同比在2023年增长了将近4倍，而我们的文创收入增长了17倍。所以说，广大人民群众对文化的需求还是非常旺盛的。所以说，在我们在文旅的融合式发展的过程中，怎么能够做好高品质建设、高品质的博物馆、图书馆、文化馆的建设，满足广大人民群众的这种文化需求？我觉得这是我们，这个整个文旅系统的一个社会责任和自己的担当。
五八同城是一个本地的生活服务信息平台，我们是连接了中小微所有的提供服务的中小微企业，把尽可能的这个社会的各种行业把它数字化，能够让老百姓能够方便的找到、精准的匹配各种需要的服务。数字化的发展里面，其实又叠加了人工智能，叠加了智能化，就智能化会再次让这个消费的匹配，这个数字消费会释放更大的潜力啊。
Some international experts also expressed optimism about China's consumption growth.
What has been catching my attention from the previous development is the move towards consumption-driven economy that China has been pushing for.I think the development of the tourism industry and also the consumption rate during the Chinese New Year, for example, is an indication for optimism.
A China conseguiu manter o consumo interno, manteve os níveis de seu comércio internacional e impulsionou novos setores, entre os quais os carros elétricos e a economia verde, em que alcançou uma liderança global.